The three tools of finance. What is finance? Finance is nothing but effective management of large amount of money. So, how efficiently we are using our money? We can answer this only if we are equipped with these financial tools. The first tool, analysis of financial statements. Analysis of financial statements is the process of reviewing and analyzing a company's financial statement to make better economic decisions. These statements include the income statements, balance sheet, statement of cash flow, and notes to accounts. 1. Balance sheets. A list of company's assets, liabilities, and equity ownership. This statement is prepared as of the date. 2. Income statement. A tally of the company's operational performance for the given period. Most often it is for the full year, but company listed in stock exchange should provide quarterly statements. 3. Cash flow statement. This records the cash changes during the accounting period, and also reconciles net income or loss to changes in cash. 4. Notes to accounts. These notes provide further information about the statement. It may be inventory management, contingent liability or owner's equity. All these should be presented in conformity with standardized accounting principles. Globally it is called IFRS. In India it is called Indiana AS. A goal of financial analysis is to equip a business with knowledge. It needs to make effective decisions. It evaluates the past and projects a company's future performance. The needs and users of the specific financial numbers vary from user to user. Investors. They look for long-term earning power of the company. Creditors. They're interested in debts and interest payment company owes, as well as its cash flows. Management will review results and search for the areas of untapped potential. Financial statements analyzing techniques. 1. Vertical analysis. Where each category in balance sheet and income statement are listed as percentage with relation to totals and sales respectively. 2. Horizontal analysis. Where we compare two or more years' data in rupees and percentage. 3. Ratio analysis. Where we calculate statistical relationship between data. The several general categories of ratios are liquidity ratio, leverage ratio, activity ratio, profitability ratios. 1. Liquidity ratios. This is the most fundamentally important set is ratios, because they measure the ability of the company to remain in business. A. Cash coverage ratio. Shows the amount of cash available to pay interest. B. Current ratio. Measures the amount of liquidity available to pay for current liabilities. C. Quick ratio. Measures the amount of liquidity available to pay for current liabilities excluding inventory. 2. Activity ratios. These ratios are strong indicators of the quality of management, since they reveal how well management is utilizing company resources. These include A. Accounts payable turnover ratio. B. Accounts receivable turnover ratio. C. Fixed assets turnover ratio. D. Inventory turnover ratio. E. Sales to working ratio. F. Working capital to turnover ratio. 3. Leverage ratios. These ratios reveal the extent to which a company is relying upon debt to fund its operations, and its ability to pay back the debt. These includes A. Debts to equity ratios. B. Debt service coverage ratio. C. Fixed charge coverage ratio. 4. Profitability ratios. These ratios measures how well a company performs in generating a profit. These includes A. Break-even point. B. Contribution margin ratio. C. Gross profit ratio. D. Margin of safety. E. Net profit ratio. F. Return on net assets. G. return on operating assets. And the best ratio is H. Return on equity. Return on equity shows companies' profit as a percentage of equity. The best model to evaluate the performance of the company is DuPont model, where DuPont tells the ultimate parameter to evaluate business performance is return on equity. If return on equity is increasing year on year, it is very good business to invest. Return on equity equals to profit after tax divided by shareholders' funds. It can be further decomposed into the product of profitability, into efficiency, into risk or leverage. 1. Profitability, which is equal to profit after tax divided by revenue, which can be further decomposed into tax factor, interest factor and operating efficiency factor. 2. Efficiency, which is equal to revenue divided by total assets, which can be further decomposed into fixed assets and current assets efficiency. 3. Risk or financial liability, leverage, which is equal to total assets divided by shareholders' fund. This video is created by Gautam V. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you.